Our next speaker is Christian Mayer. He will be talking about finite element in for structural dynamics. Please.
Okay, good. Hello? Okay. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to my talk about AMFE, finite elements for structural dynamics with simplicity in mind. My name is Christian Mayer, and I'm a PhD student at the Chair of Applied Mechanics at the Technical University of Munich, led by Professor Rixen. And today I want to talk about our finite element package, AMFE, which is an abbreviation for Applied Mechanics Finite Elements. And I want to mention my former colleague, Johannes Rutzmoser, because he was the one who started the project, and the largest amount of the code has been written by him yet. So many thanks to him. Okay, let's start with the talk. These are the contents. First, I want to motivate why yet another finite element code. Also, there are so many finite element codes open source in the internet. Then a bit about implementation, about the modules, use of SciPy and the NumPy Fortran extension. Then I will give a short example about how to use AMFE. And at last, I want to give a short outlook. Okay, first the question, why yet another finite element code? Okay, the short answer for this question is because I need it for my research. And the large answer is, okay, I have to explain what is our research. And one can summarize it in with these few words. Our research is about parametric model order reduction for nonlinear finite element simulations in structural dynamics. Okay, this sounds very complicated. Therefore, I want to explain each important term separately. First, what is structural dynamics? Structural dynamics investigates the vibrations of structures. You could imagine, for example, what are the vibrations of the blades of this wind turbine on the right, or what are the vibrations of this wing of an aircraft. For example, if you are sitting in the aircraft, traveling to EuroSciPy and the wings vibrating like the hell, you don't like that. And therefore, we want to analyze the vibrations. And either you could do it by experiments, or you could do it by simulations. And if you want to simulate it, then you usually do a finite element simulation. And what are finite element simulations? The physics behind the vibration of such structures can be written down with a partial differential equation, and finite elements is just a numerical method to solve the partial differential equation on the left. And yes, what the finite element method does is, if you want to analyze this gray potato, then you do a mesh, and then you can discretize the partial differential equations in space, and afterwards you get an ordinary differential equation where you solve the displacements for each discrete node on the mesh. And yes, the equation we want to solve is the equation which has this blue frame, and you can see it's an ordinary differential equation of second order with a nonlinear term. It's the nonlinear force term here. And okay, now the next most important term in our research is model order reduction. And what is model order reduction? You could imagine if you have industrial problems, they could be very complex, and then your equations get very high dimension. For example, you could have millions degrees of freedom, and if you want to solve the equations, it would take a lot of time, especially if you want to do design iterations or parameter studies. You have to simulate it very often, and you don't want to spend all the simulation time. So this is illustrated by this blue graph. If you increase the number of simulations, you increase the total simulation time. If you do two simulations, then you have double the time of one simulation, usually. And model order reduction, the idea behind it is that you first reduce the problem to a smaller one, and you pay reduction costs. These are this distance here. And afterwards, you only have to solve the smaller problem, and you do have to pay less computation effort. And therefore, you could save this computational time. Okay, how is this done? For the equation we have to solve, we first project the equations onto a subspace, which is represented by this matrix V. So this matrix V has millions of rows and only a few hundred columns. And then you only have to solve the equation of motion for these small amount of coordinates. You project these equations of motion, and the second thing you have to do is to apply so-called hyperreduction methods. And these hyperreduction methods speed up the evaluation of this nonlinear first term. Okay, this is our research, and to develop new methods, we have implemented a finite element code. And the features of our finite element code are the following. First, of course, we have the ability to solve nonlinear structural dynamic problems. And MFE has a modular structure and is written in Python, of course. It's interpretable. That means that we don't use input files. You can do your simulation in the console. And this is very important for us. We can very easily access and altering internal computations. This is very important because we want to develop new hyperreduction and model order reduction methods, and then we need this easy access, for example, for the assembly. And thus we can easily do rapid prototyping of new model order reduction methods. Okay. And we have, of course, already some model order reduction features. These are first some methods to calculate reduced bases. These are the matrices V. And we have some hyperreduction techniques implemented. Okay, implementation. We have some core modules just for solving the full system. And we have a mesh module with a mesh class, and the mesh module handles the mesh topology, and each mesh has many elements. So we have an element module with an element classes, and we have each element has a material assigned to it, so we have a material module. Then the assembly module handles the assembly of the mesh and its elements, and this could easily be altered for new reduction methods. And then we have boundary module for defining boundary conditions. And on top of that, there's a mechanical system module with a mechanical system class. And this offers a very handy interface to it. So it's very easy to do finite element simulations by using this handy mechanical system class. Then we have a solver. You can pass a mechanical system to the solver, and the solver solves your finite element equations. Okay, and then we have model order reduction modules, first for the reduced bases. There's some methods to calculate new reduced bases. And we have a submodule, which is called HyperRed. And there we have some submodules for different hyperreduction techniques. And we also have QM submodule. This stands for quadratic manifold, and these modules can calculate quadratic manifold bases. Okay, and we of course use SciPy and very important for us is the CSR matrix from the sparse module, because it, in finite element simulation you often have very sparse matrices, so we heavily use it. And we use some linear algorithms. And then we have programmed some Fortran extensions for the bottlenecks of our simulations, and then wrapped it with the F2Py from NumPy. Okay, how to use MFE? Here's a short example on how you could use it. First, you generate a mesh with an open source program of your choice, for example, Gmesh. Then you can define the path to your mesh file and define the output path. And then you instantiate a mechanical system object, define a material, for example, Kirchhoff material. Then you load the mesh and assign the materials to it. Then you can define the boundary conditions. Afterwards, you can solve it and export it to visualizer like PowerView. Okay, then short outlook. Further steps, we want to develop also parametric model auto reduction methods, and then we expect that we can reduce computation time for optimization, like shape optimization, or for real-time applications, we could use it. And yes, thank you for your attention and visit us on GitHub. And now I'm looking forward to your questions.
Thank you so much, Christian. Are there any questions? I have one. I wanted to ask if one can use your package for higher dimensions like 3D, and if the meshes can be also 3D meshes.
Yes, it can. We have implemented some 3D elements, and we can use it for 3D meshes too, yes.
Great. Any other question? There, one.
When I think of industrial applications, I guess this is also a regulated industry. You have to prove that things are safe, right? You would not construct a huge wind turbine on a software written by PhDs. So is there a perspective for this becoming industry-grade software?
Maybe. We have some industry partners and already has tested some models from industry to it. And of course, we also make unit tests and compare it with commercial finite element codes like ANSYS Nastran or something like that. But usually AMFE is used to do model order reduction methods, and they are still in research, but we have some industry partners and yes, has tested it for some industrial models.
Any other question? No. Thank you again for your great talk.